A while back, I was sitting in the back of a plane, and the captain came on and made an announcement and said,
Ladies and gentlemen from the flight deck, this is your captain speaking. We didn't get off the ground in time, so we're gonna have to go back and get some more gas.
So why don't the airlines or pilots fill the gas tanks up before they leave? I'll explain it all. Coming up. Hey 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. Today I'm here in Hanoi, Vietnam, and this is the view today from the hotel. Now there are two main reasons that the pilots and the airlines don't fill the gas tanks up every time before the flight. And when the captain made that announcement, I heard a bunch of the people behind me grumbling saying, why don't they just fill it up? This is so stupid. And I thought, hey, that's a great idea for a video. Let's get into it. First, I'm going to explain to you why the plane had to go back to the gate and get some more gas. When we show up to an aircraft, it gives a fuel number, and that is going to be a fuel number for takeoff and a fuel number for when we push out of the gate. Now, that number that we get to push out of the gate isn't a hard number. We don't have to have that amount of fuel on board, but the fuel number that we have before we take off, we have to have that amount of fuel. If you remember in the Soli video that I did, both pilots were checking the fuel number.
Takeoff minimum fuel quantity verified. 19,000 pounds required. We got 21.8 on board.
19,000 pounds required. 21.8 on board.
That's the fuel that we need to fly to our destination airport, and in most cases, an alternate airport or a backup airport. Now, why don't they fill it up every time? There's two real reasons. The first one is a weight consideration. Obviously, an aircraft has a certain amount of weight that it has to have or be below under in order to take off. And there's a certain weight number that the plane has to be below in order to land safely, meaning the gear is set up and structured to hold a certain amount of weight upon landing. If your plane is overweight when it takes off, it could get to the end of the runway and not have enough lift or power to get it off to the ground.
Oh, this is awkward.
Now, I personally like my job, and if you saw the video that I did with Stella, where she's asking me to make my smiley face, you remember that my smiley face isn't that great. That is my smiley face, though.
Okay.
So I'm not going to charm anybody over $1 million worth of damage because I decided to land a plane a little too heavy. So what I always do before we take off and I look at every flight is I look at the numbers to make sure that we're going to be underweight in order to take off and safely get there, and make sure that we're underweight in order to land safely and not damage the aircraft and stay within the parameters of what is safe and what is mandated by, in my case, Boeing, since I fly a Boeing aircraft. So the other reason that we don't take on all the gas that we can is that the more gas you're hauling, it has a weight to it, as you can imagine. That weight that you're hauling around is extra dead weight because you don't necessarily need it. So you end up burning a bunch of extra fuel in order to haul fuel around. So it used to be back in the day when gas was super cheap, they would just fill the tanks up. It didn't really matter. But now, as gas has gone up a lot in price, the airlines have found out and did the math that it's roughly one-third of the extra fuel that they're hauling around, they're actually burning on hauling that fuel around.
I'm sorry, but I am so confused.
So for example, if you're hauling an extra 3,000 gallons of gas around, you're burning 1,000 gallons of gas in order to haul that 3,000 gallons of gas. So you only actually have a net of 2,000 extra gallons of gas, and 1,000 of which you burned really for no reason. Speaking of jet fuel, if you haven't seen the Hollywood vs. Reality video that I did with Bruce Willis on Die Hard 2, I'm gonna put it right here. And you see him light a bunch of jet fuel on fire with a match, which you can't really do. I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.